Let's go home.
Welcome to my 5 to 9 after my 9 to 5. Let's go. We have a class to attend. It's currently this time is not correct, but close to 4:30. So yeah, asambeni and kune moto epayeka la ngemva kwami. So yeah, asambeni guys. Oh, guys, don't drive big cars, hey. Do not drive big cars. When I'm driving late because I'm saying. Okay. Hey, ngikhumile. Abase ngeshaya imoto manje. Ngeshaya imoto. So let's talk about work. I sound so excited. I had an exam. This past weekend. So I'm from Langa kahle and today I'm in class, which is just something else. And I mentioned to you guys that I'm a director of a firm. So manje, I have to put that in my schedule somehow. So ish, kuningi mfana, kuningi eningiyiwani, kuningi eningiyiwani. Okay, so I'm back home. It's a little bit dark here, so I'm not sure what the time is right now, but it's like 2:05. My class starts at 5:30, so yeah, asambeni. Hi, are you in a meeting? Is there anything in? Oh. Yep.
Congratulations.
I don't even know.
3 days. No ways.
You can't write for 3 days anymore.
No.
Why?
Without skipping a day, at least in our first day, skipping 2 days. Yeah.
No, you're given the 3 days to Bali. That's why you must go for your PhD. So I look bad. That was my dad, you guys. So. Yeah, it's currently 2 minutes. I'm sure it's 5 now. Like, I've been able 2 minutes to. So I'm just getting ready. I am just getting ready. Oh. Today, guys, we're doing personal injury, which is my favorite because I love medical law. Hey, I love medical law to the fullest. And the fact that we're doing personal injury today and tomorrow, I wish it could be the whole week, the whole course. In fact, I don't care. Because that's what I actually want to specialize in. So I'm so excited for this class today for a change. Normally, I'm just... But today, guys, I was thinking, yes, actually, in Vuxen, and I'm just like, guys, this is not the profession that I was introduced to. Sometimes I even forget to see this is the noble profession that we always talk about. And that's crazy, hey? Because, guys, I forget, this is the noble profession everyone was talking about. It is so ghetto. It's crazy. Let me just turn off this class. Like I was saying, this is not the life, Mina, that I... Not the life, but this is not the profession that I was introduced to. And not necessarily with Mina, I want all the glitz and glam and, whatever. But... Mfuna, the pizzazz, And the seriousness. Yeah, well, one thing about me, I love my job. I love my job. I look guy, but I love my job. You can tell. I do it so seriously. When I'm doing my job. So, I think this all stemmed from last week, actually. We went to Randburg and we had a maintenance matter at Randburg, and it was the actual court date. It was for a postponement, but at Randburg, even if it's for a postponement, it's court day today. Because they if it's just a postponement, you just go to the offices, which is the chambers, where you go and postpone the date, and you don't need to go to actual court. But at Randburg, you need to rope up to okay, well, Lapayana, we changed the date in my office. What we had to do at court was to, an interim order had to be made, and that interim order had to be made a court of order. So an interim order is just the order nje ukubambisa ukuthi okay, so bambisa ngalokho okwamanje until we get to the postponed date. So guys, when I got to Randburg, there is a difference in the jurisdiction that you serve. If you're serving in Pretoria, working in Pretoria as an attorney, is not the same as someone that is from, for example, Tzakane. Tzakane attorneys are not going to be the same as Randburg attorneys. Randburg, you can tell, Uti, it's all the glitz, all the glamour, all the drama. There was also drama again in Otolin, guys, that day at court. So, the girl, it was also maintenance. You could tell that it was maintenance, and the girl was calling the man a male slut. Guys, there's a lot that happens in courts, and it's just, at the same time, it's so sad because it's like, yo, bro, these are kids, the kids are involved. So yeah, like I was saying, guys, this is not the profession I was introduced to. I'm not expecting all the glitz, all the glam, but yo, it's so ghetto. It is the ghetto, the ghettoest of the ghetto. And like I said, you even forget Uti. This is a noble profession. You forget. You honestly forget. I forget sometimes, and I'm just like, oh, Gwande. I forget to go to an attorney sometimes. And I'm like, oh, I'm an attorney. I'm a cancer attorney, I'm doing my articles, and you know, I am good enough to do some things. And someone asked me about imposter syndrome as well. How's my imposter syndrome now? I don't know. Like, honestly, I honestly don't know. I don't really have imposter syndrome that I have, like, that has come to my attention. But when I get to courts, there are people that are going to make you feel as if you're inexperienced. And, you know, like, what I mean, something that I always say about myself is that I'm not dumb. I'm just inexperienced. And being inexperienced, it doesn't mean that you're dumb, because you can always learn, and you learn until you die. So, like, I always tell people, with like, just don't be afraid. And it's something that I teach myself as well. It's like, don't be afraid and don't be ashamed. If you don't know something, you don't know it. Like, my principal always says, just try out something, even in courts, you know, try out a new rule or whatever. Something that no one has ever done before. Yeah, boy. No one's gonna kill you. So just go for it, you know. And if it works, then it's something worth going for, you know. At least you did your research and whatever. So yeah, it's currently 5:15, but like, that's what I wanted to speak about with you guys, like, this profession. There are people that are okay. So why was I talking about that? Okay, I was talking about that because there's something that you have to know. You won't always secure articles in a firm that matches your aesthetic. I hope I'm making sense. Like, I think it goes for every profession. Like, we all want to be in those buildings, those high buildings, top 5, whatever, and we want to, you know, do all of that. But it's not always possible, you know. Like, you know, they all do the same thing at the end of the day, but except for the aesthetic. Yeah, boy. But yeah, like, that's something that I really, really noticed from my appearance, Iran, there is a difference. Like, there is a difference between Tina and the Randburg attorneys. The Randburg attorneys, you can tell they're all about the drama, and you'll never get that in the East Rand. So yeah, I don't know why I'm saying this, but like, I guess being Kabang and Jackson, I was like, hey. This life, yo, guys, this profession in general, it's not what I ordered. But I love it at the same time. So it's not really a love-hate relationship as yet. But yeah, there are things that I'm starting to notice with Ilana. So yeah, let's wait for passing at Balu Katala, which is so crazy. But I think I'll get into it.
When I tried to update the file, may have a new address.
Should be a problem. You know, yourself said the exact same Dropbox folder. So just log out of the.
Did any of you read the notes?
No. Say seven, like. Like, honestly.
No. Okay.
So, if we're forgetting and planning our notes, then this is also a
just put your show up and be the first few things that you need up front in order to proceed with the claim. Let's just do a quick round. Nazi, put your hands up again.
Yes, I was also just going to say that I know there's a REF claim form that needs to be filled in together with all the supporting documents.
Okay, so what are the supporting documents?
You need the awards, and I can't remember all of them. There was also.
Put your hand down. So you get an affidavit from as to how the accident happened from your client, making sure that they draft an affidavit for you or some sort of statement so you understand what happened. Somebody that now I have one for that. The, one of the most important things is something called a power button. So you guys can draft a power button in the break, so to be prepared for that period. So don't be intimidated by the notes, there's a lot of repetition. There's actually a section that's almost about 100 pages that's full of some good questions. Down, they pay you out, say, 25,000 rand, and then the rest of the claim you claim the road accident fund. However, you have to do a deduction of whatever you've already been paid out. So if Koira paid you out 25,000 rand in terms of your claim, everybody understand that. You have a motor vehicle that is stationary at a traffic light. The traffic light is red, and the person driving the motor vehicle opens their door to, I don't know, throw something out.
The person that threw the paper.
First of all, he should not be opening a door in the middle of the road. Secondly, the motorcycle should not be driving on the solid line.
You are the first person to answer that question, to be honest. Like I'm asking.
I was a taxi driver.
Okay, so the reason I asked this question, guys, so I just want to touch on that one. We'll go through it again maybe a little later. So this is what you call apportionment of damages. So remember something, if you have a motor vehicle accident, the chances of you being 100% right is very unlikely, although it can happen. So in a case like this, chances are it would be a 50% apportionment. So if you claim your damages is 200,000, the court may rule that, listen, you were 50% contributory negligent to your own detriment. So there is a section in your file which you are going to get to, which gives you examples of what is and what is not a motor vehicle. So you will have extensive information regarding it when we get to the Elijah.
Thank you.
Guys, there's a definition of a motor vehicle.
You are not allowed to claim from anyone else in respect of personal bodily injuries.
What?
The only person that's liable is the road accident fund. When we talk about motor vehicle accidents, that's a
definition. Yeah, we're on break right now. We're on break. So I'm just going to try and edit Kancane my videos because I did a vlog, a 3-day vlog. So I just want to get that out because I have to finish editing that one today, and then I'm going to be editing this one, and then I'm going to post this one. I'm gonna post this on tomorrow. So yeah, I've got quite a lot of work to do, but I'm loving this class so far. Like I said, medical law is quite the thing. Like I'm always so bored with like criminal law and whatever because it's all everyone talks about. But with medical law, personal injury, like it's another confirmation that I have to do my master's in this thing, honestly. But yeah, let me just get on to the 30-minute break. So I'll just get on to editing and then we'll be back for class.
So anything that you've read and you need some clarity on, and you know that the class is asking a lot of questions, you're more than welcome to WhatsApp me. I will definitely reply to you. And you guys need my email as well, or is my number sufficient? Okay, the chat is turned off. Okay. My email, is there any last question?
I wanted to ask in terms of future ailments or maladies in this case. If the child is injured, the child is 13 years old, and now we find that something happened and it was a result of the accident, can we then claim?
Guys, if the lecturer says the lecture is over, and then you can send questions. You know, like. There's a reason for that.
You're going to get like super special symptoms. So not to say you can't claim, you could possibly claim, but whether you have a claim or not is a question.
Tim Tuli, because you know, there's no booze again.
Yeah, I just wanted to clarify the requirement.
I don't do the assessments are done by the IBC. Glad you did, and I will see you tomorrow at 5:30. Have a good evening.
Thank you.
Okay. Bye.
thank you so much. I always find that crazy, like people, like everyone wants to say bye, but most of them are not even answering questions. But anyway, thank you guys for joining me, and I think that's the end of my 5 to 9 after my 9 to 5. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Please let me know what you guys think, and yeah guys, but otherwise have a good night. Hope you guys enjoy your day. I love you guys so much. Till my next video.